It's always good to see you.
It's always good to see you too. How are you?
Good.
Yeah, that's good.
Oh, hi, Bob.
Hi.
Rosemary's there.
Fun. What happened? You brush your teeth?
No. You're 6:30 after my class.
I'm sorry.
No, no problem.
I thought you're having fun with me.
Hey, Bob, you have to mute your line.
Pardon me?
Huh? You have to mute yourself.
Oh, okay.
Good evening, everyone. Can everyone hear me? Okay, good. Sorry. I was here like 15 minutes early, and then I got bumped off right at 6 o'clock. So I'm like, so sorry. Okay. So I'm breaking out my ukulele. Yay. All right. Welcome, Gail. Welcome, Mercedes, Elizabeth, Uncle Bob. Hi, Auntie Jovi. Welcome. Uncle Howard, Wendy. I see Joanne, Brittany. Oh, that's another Joanne. Auntie Rosie, Claire. Auntie Betty, wonderful. Welcome to all of you. Let's go. Lula, lula, lee.
Harmony
and in Hawaiian.
Aloha.
Maluhia lo kahi. Aloha maluhia lo kahi. Let's do a soul language again. Lula. Good evening, everyone. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So happy to see all of you this evening. Hi, Auntie Vicky. Welcome, welcome. It's so nice to see so many that I haven't seen in a really long time. And so we will continue on. This is our free healing evening that we have once a week. And this is the evening we focus on bringing more light, more practice, more great wisdom to all of you. And so for some of you, you have been coming and on this journey with us for several weeks now as we started the new year. Some of you have been with us for a really long time, a decade or more. And so all of you are welcome, and we're so very grateful for you being here. For those of you who are new, I'm not exactly sure who may be new, because I see a lot of people and I'm grateful for that. If you ever have a question, please put it in the chat and we will monitor that and answer your questions, okay? But for those of you who are new, the song that we just started with is Love, Peace, and Harmony. And that is a song that Master Shaw received from the divine to bring to this planet to help us all to be in oneness, to be in soulfulness, to be into transformation of our negative information into positive. And so this is a song that has helped me and my family over the last decade. So I know it well, and I know what it can do. So I wanted to start off with that song with all of you, as I do every session that I'm on. And I would like to also introduce our other lead teacher for Hawai'i and my partner for this evening, Dr. Lori Omuro Yamamoto. Say aloha, nice to see you.
Hi, everyone.
Oh, great. And so one of the things that we wanted to do, if some of you may have not seen this video, and we want to share it with you because it's something that I think, especially when I'm thrilled to watch it. But I also know that it will be helpful for all of you who may be joining us for the very first time or very new to Master Shaw's wisdom and teaching. So I'm going to let Lori, are you?
Yes, I'm. Yeah, okay. I can share.
So okay, great.
Wonderful. So thank you, everyone. Welcome. And this is a new video that just came out last week, Tuesday, to the public. And it's a wonderful video about our teacher, Dr. Master Shaw, Tao Calligraphy. And this is something that you can find on YouTube and hopefully share it with others that you may feel could really benefit from all of his wisdom and transformative powers. So let me share with you the video. Let me see. Okay. So can you see this? Everybody can see Master Shaw on the screen? Right. Wonderful.
Please. Millions of people meditate, positive thinking, and a special healing mantra or healing song, wonderful. But I think mind over matter is not enough. The next step is soul over matter. Soul over matter, soulfulness means our soul can make things happen.
Master Zhigong Sha studied to be a medical doctor in Western medicine from China. Through this journey, he came to learn of a 5,000-year-old practice in traditional Chinese medicine. This revolutionized both his practice and his healing gifts. This is his story.
While I was in a medical college, Xi'an Medical College, one time I think at the restaurant, the meat spoiled. Then I took it, then I have vomiting, diarrhea, and the meditation cramp. Then midnight, I went to emergency. They give me injection in modern medicine. That's it works. Ayoh, pain. I drink water, pull throughout. I have a classmate. He is the traditional Chinese medicine lineage family. But he studied modern medicine as me, classmate. And he came down to my room. He said, lie down. I lie down, lie on the stomach. And he put his hands on my inner thigh and also my lower back. And he said, relax. He moved the finger, moved my tendon. I was shouting, oh, very painful, very forceful, move my tendon. And then he said, drink the water. I said, I cannot drink anything. He said, big bowl of water, drink it. I drink it. I was totally okay. I have such a deep impression. I said, wow, Chinese medicine, 5,000 years history. There must be something.
This experience, along with many more, changed Master Sha's trajectory from studying strictly Western medicine to also studying traditional Chinese medicine. He received his MD degree in Western medicine from China. He also became a doctor of traditional Chinese medicine and acupuncture. As a lifelong student of ancient Chinese wisdom, Master Sha has come to learn this one eternal truth.
Millions of people in China know these three words, Shen, Qi, Jing. But I have realized Shen, Qi, Jing is more than people understand.
In traditional Chinese medicine, Shen, Qi, Jing are known as the three jewels or three treasures. Shen is the soul, Qi is energy, and Jing is essence or matter. Master Sha has learned and further teaches that everything and everyone is made up of soul, heart, mind, energy, and matter. Or in other words, we are all made up of Shen, Qi, Jing.
During my study, through the whole life, I have realized Shen, Qi, Jing is a universal law. Everyone, everything is made of Shen, Qi, Jing. Shen includes soul, heart, and mind. So in spiritual realm, soul is the spirit. But in quantum physics and Tao science, soul is the information. They are the same. Millions of people believe here, soul and spirit. Millions of people believe scientific way. But in fact, they are the same. Information is your soul. So therefore, this is like an information system we share with humanity in Tao science.
To further explain, the soul is the warehouse where information is stored. Our heart is the receiver, which transmits the information to the mind. Our mind is the processor or interpreter of the information received. Our mind, in turn, directs the energy and initiates actions. This energy, or qi, dictates the actions of matter. Matter, known as jing, can be defined as our physical body, physical environment, and physical circumstances. Knowing this, both the positive and negative information we consume play a crucial role in the outcome of our lives.
Positive information causes great results for health, relationship, finances. If you connect with negative information, you are affected. We do Tao Calligraphy. We connect with the source. This is a positive information.
Tao Calligraphy is a revolutionary healing art based on an ancient form of one-stroke calligraphy, Ibitsu, which he learned from the soul lineage holder, Professor Li Chu Yun. Master Sha further developed this oneness writing to create a powerful vibrational field that carries the positive messages of Tao source, such as the greatest love, forgiveness, harmony, flourishing, and more. Through this, we can transform negative information and energy in our own vibrational field by absorbing the positive information and energy generated through tracing of Tao calligraphy. This can result in positive changes and profound healing in our lives, as has been the case for hundreds of thousands of people whom Master Sha has served.
Tao calligraphy creates source healing field that can serve all life, including health, relationship, and finances. I am delighted and excited to invite you to join the masterclass taught by Master Teacher Vanessa, Rejuvenation Prolonged Life, as well as Transformation of Relationship and Finances. Welcome you.
Beautiful. That voice, that touches my heart. I didn't actually see that last part. That's beautiful. So thank you. Anybody have any comments that they would like, one or two people would like to share their comments about what you just saw? Any aha moments? Okay. I always, I never get tired of Master Sha explaining Shen Qi Jing. That's something that we are bringing together, our soul, heart, mind, energy, matter, is something that is quite profound to, I think, humanity. And it's something that I continuously talk to my friends about as they are trying to figure out why things are going wrong, or why their health isn't so good, or how their relationships aren't so healthy, or why their finances are not aligned. So just because we are students or maybe not students, continue to watch that. That's something that I rotate over and over whenever I have a free moment, because it really starts to make sense for people once they really start to go, huh, that's so interesting. And it helps to expand the mindsets, yeah, or the good, the positive information within us, I should say. So, okay. I would like to check in, if that's okay. Lori, is that okay if we check in with...
Yes, Howard is willing to share how he's doing from last week.
Oh, fabulous.
Yeah. He's here again. Welcome.
Wonderful. So those who may have not been here last week, Uncle Howard here is from Maui, and he received Tao light holes for his pain, for his back that was existing for weeks. And so, hi, aloha, Uncle Howard. Welcome.
Wow. Can you hear me?
Yeah, there's a little bit of an echo, so I'm gonna mute myself.
Okay. Is it still doing that? Okay.
I wonder if you have a couple devices on. Do you have like a couple devices on? It's better now.
Okay. Okay, it was a really wow moment for me. I didn't really expect all that to happen, but it did. And after I got the transmission, the three transmissions, one for the message center, the second one for the C7 vertebrae, and the third one was for my first soul house, I felt very different. Okay, so I kind of made a little journal as to how things went. Tuesday, before that, the pain level was 10 plus. And on Tuesday, it was fluctuating between 3 and 6. Wednesday, between 2 and 6. And on Wednesday, my my friend Richie came to visit me while I was in bed, because those days I had a hard time trying to get out of bed. And he was telling me that, hey, let's get going. You know, you can do it. Okay, anyway, Thursday was the first time I had a chance to walk to the kitchen. You know, most of the time I was in bed. Okay, Friday, I got up sore. And Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, all the days that followed, I was really, pain was kind of sore in the morning. But once I get going, it was really good. So on Friday, I went outside and I trimmed the hedges for about 10 minutes. But the thing about this was that every time I did the practice, I could see a lot of darkness coming out. When I do the practice for my message center, the light hole just sucks up all the darkness. And then the C7 vertebrae, same thing, as well as the first soul house. It was something that, you know, I was really improving day by day. But my suffering was so severe that, at the beginning, when I were to sit down on a chair, when I had to stand up, I had to kind of rock myself back and forth, trying to pick up speed. And a lot of times I, did not get off the ground. And my feet would be stuck on the ground and I just couldn't go. You know, everything was like cemented. The only thing was going was my toes. So with my toes, I kind of wiggled around like a worm. So another thing I noticed was that when I had to step up, like our house, we had to kind of make a step to get into our house. And even that was very difficult. But with all the transmissions that was given, all the blessings from Malia, Laurie, Chiemi and Annette, slowly things started to gel. Everything came to be more of a wow, this is really this is really happening to me, and I'm really grateful that I have wonderful servants to get me off the ground. And I cannot thank you guys enough for putting all these healing sessions together. Because I remember Annette used to always call me almost daily, talk to me or my wife and seeing how I was doing. And it was something that it really touched my heart. You know, thank you, Annette. And Laurie was always there. Messaging me and Chiemi with the practice session, and and of course you, Malia, was very instrumental in making this come true for me. And I feel at this time I'm on the road to recovery, and every day I'm doing more and more, and pretty soon I'll be seeing you at the swim meet. This past Saturday was a bit too soon yet, and plus it was in Lahaina, so I said, I'm going to pass on this one. But I want to thank you all because, I pretty much held off on this for a long time. I was kind of suffering. I wanted to get this off the ground by myself, but I just couldn't. So finally, one day I told my wife, I think I got to call Annette, and she was shocked. I said, what? Yeah, I think I better call Annette because I think I suffered enough already and there's nothing more I could do to get me off the ground. So I want to thank you all for being there for me. And I feel that, anybody who is suffering, these three transmissions are it. It's to me, it's a must, because if you want to heal fast and try to get going on your life, I would highly recommend that the transmissions are real, and make it happen for yourself. So I want to thank you all, Master Shaw, the divine Tao source, for all the support that you have given me this past week. And I am pretty much sold on this transmission. It really works. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone. Give Uncle Howard a clap. Wonderful. Thank you, thank you. I'm so happy to hear and to see you too, because you look different too. You look like there's a calm that's with you that was not with you last week.
Yeah, probably the last time I saw you, I had black hair. But now my wife said I gotta act my age. Yeah, but, you know, we had our last child was born when my wife was 43. So you know, her classmates probably gonna say, hey, your parents still looking young, so I had to make my hair black. Cool, and she's all up and running. You know, I say, you know what? I gotta act my age already.
Beautiful. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Is Auntie Betty here this evening?
I'm here.
Oh, aloha, Auntie Betty. How are you doing?
As far as my back, you know, I'm really feeling better after the demo 2 weeks ago. And I did share with Laurie in the email, but she wanted me to share tonight. And I can share, you know, I can attest to what Uncle Howard is going through, because I have the same thing. My back is just really, really bad. And I know when he, you know, couldn't stand it anymore, he called Annette. And when I got on 2 weeks ago and I was the demo for that, I really, being kind of new at this, I really didn't know what demo meant. But I had talked to Annette and Laurie, and they explained to me. So I was really excited, because I was kind of desperate. You know, my back was so bad. I even had to cancel my trip to Maui because I couldn't sit down like Howard, sit down, and I couldn't stand up. And I had to, for several days, I was kind of standing up, leaning on a chair and having my dinner and eating meals. And so after the demo, and you transmitted the Huiyin light ball or light hole, I really couldn't believe what was happening to me. You know, it was kind of unbelievable, because all of a sudden I didn't feel any pain. And I, you know, was kind of doubtful. And I said, gosh, I'm wondering if that transmission just helped me at that moment, you know. And later on, after our session finished, I was still with no pain. So I said, it has to be that. So the next day I talked to Annette, and Laurie texted me and explained what I got, and I confirmed that it was the transmission. And I'm really, really thankful, because to this day I'm feeling pretty good. I think my level of pain at that time, that night, was about an 8, but I can say now it's about 3 and 4 now. So I think it's more than 50%. So I thank everybody for all your love and blessings. And I thank you, Balia, your transmission. I could feel it. It was very strong. very, very strong. And I really thank everybody. Thank you very much.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, Auntie Betty. I wish I could take any credit for that, but this is all our beloved teacher, Master Shaw, that's given me, has given Auntie Pam the authority to be able to transmit this. And it is very powerful. And we're so, so happy to hear your progress and how you are moving along in that and also doing the practices. The practices are also very key to this. So thank you both, Uncle Howard.
Yes, Malia, I want to also mention that Annette, called me and asked if she could help with the practice, but I think I was, you know, on my way. So I do say that mantra for the Huiyin light hole, and it's working. It's wonderful. Working. So thank you, Annette, for thank checking you. Up on me.
Yes, and thank you, Auntie Annette and Lori, Chiami, all of our master teachers yes. who check up on your students, your clients, the people who you are taking care of. We have an amazing team in Hawaii, and I'm really grateful that we all are able to serve in this way. So thank you, thank you, thank you for that, Auntie. Okay, so what better way to continue on than to do a practice? Whatever we have, and those are you, kid, is there anyone who is new here this evening? If you could just put in the chat, if you are new to Master Shaw's teaching, that way we know, we can explain a little bit more. If you are new, I want to make sure that you know what's going on. So one of the things that is really profound, what has been very profound for me, and something that Master Shaw continues to teach, is breathing. And, you know, many years ago, my husband said, I'm going to take you to a breathing class. I'm like, what? A breathing class? Are you serious? And he's like, you don't know how to breathe. And I was like, this was like, I think 10 years ago. And I'm like, what does that mean? And then I realized, because I worked in, I worked for the university, and I was always so stressed, and I only breathed right here into my chest, not down to my lower abdomen. So he had one on me at that point in time. Now our teacher continues to teach this. It's like, I didn't learn from Master Shaw. I learned from outside. But the thing is that we're not actually conscious of what we're doing a lot of times when it's something as simple as breathing. Because we sometimes think, if we have not learned it properly, that, oh, we're just breathing. I'm just breathing. But it really makes a difference. And so I would like you, if you have not learned this practice or are new to it, I would like to teach you. Okay. So we're breathing in, and we're breathing all the way down to our lower abdomen. Okay. So I would like you to close your eyes and place your hands in your lower abdomen. Take a deep breath in and breathe all the way down to your lower abdomen. So I've been really fortunate. I have a granddaughter now, and I get to watch how she breathes, and her stomach goes whoop, up and down, up and down. So we're going to breathe just like babies do, all the way down to your lower abdomen. Your stomach should expand in this breathing. Okay. So deep breath in and then release. One more time, deep breath in. And then release. Last time, deep breath in. And then release. Perfect. So what Lori has done is she has put up Da Quan Shu, or greatest forgiveness. This is Master Shaw's Tao Calligraphy healing art. And so the second step with this process or this practice is, as you are breathing in, you're going to breathe this frequency of this calligraphy, this the love and light that comes with this healing art. Okay, so deep breath in, and as you're breathing in, breathe in all of the light and love from this calligraphy. Da Quan Shu is what you will say as you're releasing. Da Quan Shu. Deep breath in. Da Quan Shu. And what happens is you're breathing in the pure light and love of the source. And as you're releasing, the negative information from your body. Okay, deep breath in. Da Quan Shu. Deep breath in. Da Quan Shu. Perfect. Deep breath in. Da Quan Shu. Positive light, love, frequency, vibration in. Da Quan Shu. Negative information releasing. Deep breath in. Da Quan Shu. Perfect. Deep breath in. Da Quan Shu. Xi Xing is deep breath in. Xi Xing. Da Quan Shu. Hu Zhuo is deep, is breath out. Xi Xing, deep breath in. Da Quan Shu. Release all the negative information. Deep breath in. Xi Xing. Da Quan Shu. Xi Xing. Da Quan Shu. Breath in. Da Quan Shu. Deep breath in. Da Quan Shu. Da Quan Shu. Hu Zhou. Breathe out. Breath out. Xi Xing. Da Quan Shu. Xi Xing. Da Quan Shu. silently breathe in. Ooh, draw. Shi Xing. Ooh, draw. Visualize the light coming in 360 degrees in all parts of your body. It's filling us with light in all parts of our body, from the top of our head to the bottom of our feet, skin to bone. How? So how is everything? Everything is perfect. Everything is perfect. Everything is well. How is Mandarin? How? Thank you. So you know the really cool thing about this exercise, or this practice? You can do it anywhere. You can do it when you're walking. You can do it when you're in the shopping center. You can do it when you're sitting down and watching the television, or you're cleaning your dishes. Wherever you want to do this, you can do this. It's really simple. And you keep taking those breaths. You can use any calligraphy that you have. You can use this. Oh, can you see that? Oh, you can't see that. Can you see that? Let me undo this. Let me undo my virtual background. Okay. You can use your greatest love book. You can use, I have a lot of books right here. You can use your greatest forgiveness book. If you have any of these books, you can use any of them, right, to do this practice and focus on them when you're doing it. Okay. So, can I have any feedback from anyone that would like to say anything about this very short practice? I think we did it for about 7 or 8 minutes.
I'd like to share, Malia.
Oh, fabulous. Thank you, Mercedes.
Well, it is in line with all the pains that people are feeling. You know, I have been through that for so many years. And then what I would do is just, okay, let me take a pill so it will go away. Mm-hmm. So that's what I would do. And then finally, I cannot take it anymore. I went to do acupuncture. Mm-hmm. So it didn't improve still.
Mm-hmm.
Then last 3 years ago, I went for a stem cell treatment because I have read that, okay, let's do a stem cell because, you know, if you put in like new, I don't know, I can't remember where they got the, you know, the stem cell thing, but it was not easy. It was so painful.
Oh, wow.
Because they have to extract blood from where you are having problem, and then they have to inject it back. There is a process that they call it, but I can't remember anymore. So I didn't even finish the other foot because I said to the doctor, I said, I can't take it anymore. Maybe I cannot even walk back or walk home. Wow. Or go home. I cannot talk. So I leave it that way. So then years go by, I work, and then still after half day of working, I would be in pain. My coworker would say, what's wrong with you? Why are you limping? I said, my feet hurts, but still I have to continue working, you know? So finally I said, okay, maybe I should go to the orthopedic. So I did. No, the chiropractor. So I did. So I asked for a leave of absence for a week or 2 weeks. And finally I was off working. So, but I am doing something else. I'm doing my other business. So I was off, but I'm not saying I'm relieved from the pain. The pain is still there. So then at first I saw the Mind Valley, if you have heard about Mind Valley. So I went to hear about it. I even recorded it. So they will teach you what to do, blah, blah, blah. And I said, okay, let me try this. Maybe this will work. But then it did not work. So I said, okay, leave it that way. After a year, then I saw this on Facebook, this Tao Hands Healing Practitioner. So when I saw it, I said, oh, this is what I need. So right away, I put in my name. And then so the following day, Yanan texted me and called me, okay, when you're ready, you just let me know and we will register. So I said, okay, no questions asked. I just register. So then the classes start. It was Chiami was my teacher, my master teacher, and Miss Gail was my master teacher. So they taught, okay, you have to chant this, blah, blah, blah. So when I went to the mall one time, I have to return something. And then I said, oh, okay, let me go pass by the store, but I have to walk. So then it went to my mind that, oh, let me practice the chanting, you know, so the soul language. So I was walking, I was doing my soul language. And then I was surprised. I said, I was walking, but I didn't feel any pain. So I said, oh, wow. I said, could this be it? So then I did not put any doubt, but I was just amazed. I was just like, this thing really did to me? You know, so then the classes went on, and sometimes if you were fed with so much information, after that, I wouldn't know anything. I wouldn't remember anything. So I would do is I would go back to the recording. I would look at the recording, listen to it again, and I said, okay, I should do this. So my mind is like focused and I can do it, I will do it, I'm committed to do it. So, and I also had a blessing for my feet, for special blessing. I asked for that, aside from my eye, and then what else did I do? And my feet, I think there were three, but I have all the energies that, you know, I got a blessing with. And I would say miraculously, or it's because I'm religiously or diligently doing it, I don't feel any pain in my feet anymore. Even if I do long standing in the kitchen, because sometimes people order food from me and I also say, yes, yes, yes. And only a few like selected people. So I said, oh my God, yes, thank you. I'm already at the end of my rope. What can I do? With my feet, I'm going to be sitting down and not being able to be mobile. And I can't take that. I cannot take that really. So I have to do something. I have to find something. So I'm just so happy that I went into this journey. And then.
Thank you. Thank you. We're so happy that you're here. And thank you for sharing your story with us, because, you know, we have Tao Hands coming up too. We have Gail, our trainer here, and we have, I think Chiemi's here too, or she might be here as well. And so this is a really great reminder for all of us to encourage our friends, our family members, just people we may meet. They just may come to you. We have our first level coming up very, very soon. Level one, Tao Hands Healer, that's that training that's coming up very, very soon. So thank you for sharing that with us tonight, Mercedes. Wonderful. I want to
Give it back to you. Yeah. So maybe the skill maybe can share is when with the Tao Hands. Gail, you wanted to share something?
Yes, I wanted to share that Mercedes is an A student and she is an unconditional servant. She serves other people, her friends, her people from her church group. And we explained that the more you serve, the more you receive as well. And so congratulations, Mercedes. You are a very good example for all of us with your service. Thank you.
Let's all give Mercedes a hand. Thank you, Mercedes. Yay. Thank you, Gail, for helping us to understand that more too, because, you know, it's always good when we have our hamana, our students, and we see them thrive and flourish that way. It's always beautiful to hear that. So thank you. I would like to hand this over, if it's okay, with Auntie Pam, because we are going to our demo this evening. And this is another special person that we all has done so much for Hawaii and our teams for a really, really long time. So I'm going to hand this over to Auntie Pam to introduce our demo this evening.
Thank you so much, Malia. Very happy to be here tonight. And as Malia has shared, our next demo is someone who has started all of this beautiful gathering of students on Kauai, the island of Kauai. And I'll let Vicky share, you know, what that special time was. But she, along with another very sweet, beautiful healer, Jovi Guerrero, had met Master Shah on the island of Kauai. Vicky also invited or hosted Master Shah and the whole crew, the AV team, and all those that were involved in creating beautiful documentaries, you know, segments of videos and everything that were filmed on Kauai for almost a whole month. And Master Shah spent the entire time at Vicky's home. She had opened her home, a very beautiful home, to Master Shah and a few very special teachers there who had joined him on this 1 month excursion. At the time, Diane Fujio was also partnered with me in starting groundwork activity on the island of Oahu. And we were also intricately involved in hosting Master Shah at that time. So it was a long time back, and Vicky has contributed over the years in sharing Master Shah's teachings with several groups on Kauai. And I had a text message from Vicky a couple of nights ago, and she said that she was in pain. There was pain in her right side. She had driven herself over to Wilcox Hospital on Kauai and was admitted to the hospital. And we can have Vicky share more information. They found other things that we need to address tonight. And it is with heartfelt thanks and gratitude to this beautiful healer and servant and supporter of Master Shah that I am so honored to offer blessings to Vicky tonight. So Vicky, could you please come on the line and share with us your story? Vicky, are you still with us? I saw you very briefly. I saw a hospital bed. On video. Okay, so I'm not sure what is happening. So Malia, may I step outside of the screen for a moment?
Yes.
Then I will connect with Vicky.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
Wonderful. So while we're, because, you know, she's in the hospital right now. So anything could be, she could be getting checked up on, you know, there could be anything. It could be internet. It could be anything. So while we are doing that, let us all turn on our divine Tao source treasures that we have. And every single person has one. Just saying, every single person has one, whether you've been a Master Shaw student or not. There are really great, amazing, I want to say you have your own powers that we can focus on. Oh, and Lori is so gracious to put the Da Quan Chu, greatest forgiveness, back up. And we can do, we can sing. I would like to do that. It's so simple. It seems so simple, but what it's doing is it's increasing our frequency, increasing our vibration, our abilities to help each other and to help all, where you're in your space, your home, wherever you are, and be also be able to share that love and that support to others, your animals and beyond, okay? All right, so we can sit up. Place your one hand on an area that you would like healing on. Well, it could be your heart, it could be your head, it could be wherever you need support or healing. If you're like, Malia, I don't need any healing, then place both of your hands on your lower abdomen, right below your belly button, right on your lower abdomen, and you can rejuvenate also, okay? So close your eyes. And we are going to say Da Quan Chu, or greatest forgiveness. And so those of you who already know this song, you can sing with me. Da Quan Chu, Da Quan Chu, Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu, Da Quan Chu, Da Quan Chu, Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu, greatest forgiveness, greatest forgiveness, greatest forgiveness, greatest forgiveness. Greatest forgiveness, greatest forgiveness, greatest forgiveness, greatest forgiveness. Greatest forgiveness. Take a deep breath in, Qi Xing. Breathe in the light. Hu Zhong. Qi Xing. Da Quan Chu. Deep breath in. If there's any relationships, any challenges, greatest forgiveness. Da Quan Chu. Focus on one thing. Qi Xing, deep breath in. Da Quan Chu.
Deep breath in. Da-quan-chu. Focus in on this area that you would like healing and blessing and rejuvenation for. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. As we're doing this practice, just watch your mind, see what might be popping up for you, sometimes even a person, like the visualization of a person may be coming to you, someone that you need to give forgiveness to or receive forgiveness from. Visualize that person with you or that situation or condition, and give the greatest forgiveness, including yourself, including yourself. Da Quan Chu. 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 Take a deep breath in. Shi Xing. Deep breath in, receiving the light from this amazing calligraphy, higher frequency vibration. Hu Zhou. Releasing the negative information. Shi Xing. Hu Zhou. Shi Xing. Hu Zhou. Hao, hao, hao. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Love you, love you, love you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Da Quan Chu. You know, sometimes when I do these practices, like something will just come up into my mind, or like a memory, or like a picture of somebody, like, oh, just like cross my mind. I don't know if that happens to anybody else. But that's something that happens to me. And when that happens, then I know I need to take care of something, situation. And sometimes it doesn't even, I may not even understand it. Sometimes it might be just something that comes, yeah, to her or to me. Oh, hi, Auntie Vicky. Aloha. Love you. Okay, I'm going to let Auntie Pam come back on. Nice to see you, Auntie. Love you. Thank you so much again, Malia. And it's so good to see you, Vicky. We're all here for you. You are in our hearts. And we send you our love and all the best. Vicky, are you able to talk a little bit? Are you okay to share?
I can. Yes.
You can? Oh, okay. Thank you.
You want me to share something or?
Yeah, whatever you feel comfortable sharing.
Well, I've been quite uncomfortable on Saturday morning. I have very sharp pains on my right side. Mm. So I immediately took myself to urgent care. Mm-hmm. And within a couple hours, they had me in emergency CT and admitted me to the hospital.
Okay.
So it's been somewhat very comfortable, of course, because we're teaching our wonderful teacher, Master Shaw, and all of you. I came out of surgery today, and I'm pretty like wiped out. So I'm just trying to, stay focused. Thank you. And thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much for sharing, Vicky. We will do our best with Master Shah's blessings and high-level treasures to get you back on your feet as soon as possible. There are several areas that we need to address tonight. I offer Vicky all three light holes and liquid springs. We'll start with the Shanzhong, the Huiyin, and Dajue. Okay? So this is all from the love of Master Shah and his heart of service. So it is truly our honor and our pleasure to serve you tonight. You have been such a wonderful, wonderful student, healer, servant there on the island of Kauai for many, many years. How many years was it, Vicky, that you...
We're going to start our 12th year in February.
Very soon.
Seems like a long time, but it's worth every year of it.
Yes, yes, yes. I know your heart. Okay, so totally relax, Vicky. Close your eyes, and I will offer you our three treasures. Hao, Tao Golden Light Hole, and Tao Golden Liquid Spring for Shanzhong to Vicky Ramos. Transmission. Hao, Tao Golden Light Hole, and Tao Golden Liquid Spring for Huiyin to Vicky Ramos. Transmission. Hao, Tao Golden Light Hole, and Tao Golden Liquid Spring for Dajue to Vicky Ramos. Transmission. They're all treasures, join as one and turn on 24/7 at this time for Vicky Ramos. Transmission. How. Thank you. So Vicky, just lie there, receive, open your whole heart, soul, and every part of you to receive all the blessings of love, of light, of the highest and finest vibration and frequencies to heal as soon as possible. And at this time, I would like to call upon Diane for any third eye visions that came to you and anyone else who would like to share.
Thank you, Master Pam, for that beautiful blessing. You know, we love Vicky so much. It's so nice to see her. Yes. Everything you said about her, she's very deserving. And you know, the thing about Vicky, she's very humble.
Yes.
She didn't ask unless it was pretty serious.
Yes.
So those Tao Source light holes were life-saving for our beloved Vicky. She's a great practitioner. She's a kind and caring person. She has lots of virtue because she does good things for other people, always putting others before herself. So she receives, and she has a huge heavens bank. But sometimes, you know, our ancestors and our past lives, they catch up with us when we didn't have the higher wisdom. We didn't have the sacred wisdom. We didn't have the Tao Source practices and teachings. And we just lived an ordinary life. So those messages and that warehouse of information that wasn't the highest in past and ancestors come to us. Why? Not because we're so bad, but because they want to transform. So when I saw the light hole blessing, the light that was streaming in, huge, and to call it a hole is a misnomer, because it was a reverse, like huge, you know, those giant mega lights that they shine around the world. It was a giant mega light from the source into Vicky in her message center, in her weigh-in, in her dajue on the nape of her neck, which really helped her wai jiao, her san jiao, the three sections of her body. And the light that was just coming in. And then I also saw like dark dust going out of her. Countless, countless blockages were being released. Countless. And like I said, this is life-saving. It's nourishing her systems, her organs. That's related to that area that she just had her surgery. It's nourishing all of her blood. It's nourishing her major organs, her 14 major organs. It's nourishing her brain, her heart, you know, the essential organs and systems in her body. And it's not only reversing out the negativity, it's giving a lot more positivity, especially rejuvenation, yeah, stamina, vitality, and prolonged her life. And I'm just so happy because of all people, Vicky is so deserving. And I also saw Master Shah. Master Shah came, and as you were saying transmission, he said transmission. And he sent like extra lightning bolts into that. Can't call it a hole because it's a floodlight, but he sent extra transmissions to Vicky. So you're very, very blessed. Very, very blessed.
Thank you so much, Diane. And if you have some little ounce of energy to share, Vicky, that would be fine. If not, you know, please continue to rest. Okay. So if anyone else have seen or heard something that would like to share, please, we welcome you to share.
I would like to share Auntie Annette. She wrote something. She said, "Dear Vicky, I am sending you love and blessings for a speedy recovery as appropriate. I thank you for all your support and love you have given to Master Shaw's organization. You give so unconditionally. I thank you from my heart. This blessing was truly life-saving for you. Thank you, Master Shaw. Thank you, beloved Pam.
Thank you so much, Annette. And thank you, everyone. I can feel your love for Vicky. And Vicky, you're so very, very blessed. Thank you. Thank you for all that you've done and do continue to do, Vicky. Malia.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Auntie Pam. Thank you so much, Auntie Vicky, for being here. You know, I want to emphasize Ohana again. Auntie Vicky, several years ago when Master Shaw came to Hawaii, she crocheted, I don't know how many lays, hundreds of them. And she sent them from Kauai to Master Shaw's event for every single person who came. And she wanted to create Ohana for the world so that the world would understand what we are. Master Shaw says he is creating a love, peace, harmony, world family. And in that single act, she helped people all over the world who are walking through those doors to have something forever.
Wasn't that over 500 lays?
It was a lot because there were a lot of people. And she did it so fast too. It wasn't like it was, I don't know, maybe it's a couple, like a month and a half, maybe even a month. It was fast. She's like nodding. Mm-hmm. She was working hard to make that all happen. And I, so when I just did a talk in the Netherlands a couple weeks ago and I gave a lay and the reaction from Dennis, who is the head of the Netherlands, the lead teacher and director, said, I remember that when I came to Hawaii, I got a lay, you know? So this is what our Ohana does. Mm-hmm. And I'm so happy, Auntie Vicky, that you contacted us, Auntie Jovi, that you were you just connected. And please, 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 everyone, this evening is for Ohana, and our Ohana is everyone connected to us, right? So we as practitioners, we as students of Master Shaw, we all like hanging out together, and that's a good thing. But we want to also make sure that our Ohana, whether it's your biological Ohana, it's your friends and colleagues, that kind of Ohana, it's your sports, your kids' sports Ohana or school Ohana, whatever, because we all have different kinds of Ohana all over. So we want to bring these, all of our teams, all of our people who support us, all the people we love and care for, to this evening so that we can start to bring greater wellness, greater support, whether it's for the information mattered energy, whatever it is that they need, that we can also assist them. And we will check in with Auntie Vicky in the next week or a couple weeks as she can to help her. And we will have also that support for her. Also with Auntie Jovi, we all come together. I always say we like to collapse on each other to make sure that everybody is getting what they need, because that's what Ohana do. That's what we do. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you all for being here. If you have any questions, please, please, please let us know. We are available through the center. We are available, you know, almost every night. Let me check my calendar. Every night we have something going on, whether it's the part of the membership, which I will have Lori talk about in the next few minutes, or if it's coming to Thursday evening, you can come and you can receive. We have Tao light massage, Tao meditation. We have Tao Tai Chi. We have all kinds of services that are available in whatever way that you want to receive it. We have them available for you. And where is, I'm going to call upon.
There's a few people who want to share. Go ahead.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Great.
I wanted to share about Vicky because, you know, you're talking, I was going to mention about the lay making. And, you know, I was on the greeting committee. And, you know, as you mentioned, Vicky is a silent servant. She would let all of us and, you know, put the lays on and greeted all of the participants. And the reaction that we received, it was really heart-touching. And here was Vicky in the background, not even taking credit. I mean, that's the kind of person she is. She is such an unconditional servant. So I love you, Vicky. Get well quickly.
Could we have Vicky's permission to offer her Tao Hands blessings when we do our morning practice? Tao Hands.
Sure.
Thank you, Vicky. Yes, we get together every morning by teleconference, so we will include you very, very gratefully.
Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to send this back to Lori before. Well, let me read a couple before. One is from Jamie. Dearest beloved Auntie Vicky, we love you so much. Yes, I remember all of the lays and beautiful pouches that you created. Sorry, it's moving now. There's more comments. Sorry, let me go back up. Pouches that you created from your generous heart. Thank you so very much for your unconditional love and support. All of us and our beloved Ohana on Kauai, sending you greatest love and blessings as appropriate. Love you. And then from Gail. Dear Auntie Idi Vicky, we love you. Congratulations on receiving these golden light holes. Our thoughts and blessings for speedy recovery. Get well, Tao. And then we have Susan Aragaki. We'll send blessings, dear Vicky, with emojis. Yes, yes, yes. Wonderful. And then Joanne says, love and blessings, Joanne and Angel Momo. Beautiful. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone. Beautiful. Okay. Thank you, Laurie.
Oh, wonderful. So thank you, everyone, for joining. It's so wonderful to have all these neighboring islands from all over Hawaii and California and maybe even beyond to join us in this special evening. We thank Malia, Auntie Pam, we thank Vicky, we thank Howard and Auntie Betty for sharing, and we thank, of course, our teacher, Dr. and Master Jigong Sha, who made all of this possible for us. And, you know, the video we played, there's some new videos that will be coming out. And, you know, if it opened your heart like it did ours, hopefully, and that you feel that you can share it with your loved ones, this is a wonderful way to have your family, your friends, colleagues learn a little bit more about what's out there, because as you see, we are really creating these miracles. I mean, you know, heaven through the grace of Master Sha's empowerments, many of the master teachers, you advanced students and Tao Hands healers are creating miracles. Mercedes, just a new Tao Hands healer, you know, serving so well. And so please help to serve so many people who may not know of this and can be relieved of their pain and suffering. You know, we have the Tao Hands coming up. So please help to invite them to join. Help them to bring them here to this free Tao healing evening or Tao calligraphy healing evening. And as we said, we are still working on a process to maybe have people, you know, if you have, you know, family, friends, loved ones who are new and would be okay about sharing what their condition is and being a demo so they could experience this kind of healing, you know, please contact, you know, Malia and me, and we will be, you know, processing that until we have like a more formal kind of way of doing this. And we also have Thursday evenings. Next month, we'll start this Soul Secrets. Will be 1 hour. And this is like basic wisdom that you can invite your loved ones to get these bite-sized, you know, secrets, these nuggets of wisdom that they can maybe process more easily and not feel too overwhelmed. And then every other week for you Tao Hands healers, we will have a healer gathering so we can all serve each other, we can reconnect and, you know, really take our service to the next level. And really, as Malia says, be ohana, we can, because it's so nice now, all the islands are joined together. We'd love to see all of you to come out for these services. And we'll have the continuing Tao Calligraphy membership program. You know, those are wonderful for, there's three different packages that can fit anyone's needs and time commitments. They are all recorded. So even if you can't join live, you can watch the recordings to, you know, receive the benefits. And especially when we are healing and when we're busy, that's when we need it the most. You know, sometimes you might miss the live, but then I can go to sleep with the recordings or, you know, kind of just meditate and you just feel so refreshed. And there's so much things can be, you know, cleared from us, especially during this year of the young water tiger. Very exciting year, a lot of things happening. So we really want to have a feel that we can feel protective, that can cleanse us. So please also join us there. Invite your friends to join us as well. And we have many other you know, programs with consultations plus blessings. And all of the master teachers can do personal consultations. So if you have a concern, you have a loved one, and they want more of that one-on-one, you know, it's hard for them to be in the group right now, please contact any of the master teachers in the center to get more information. So thank you again, everyone, for joining us. And I apologize for being a minute over, but I'll let Malia close us with a beautiful song.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Lori. Let us end this night with the greatest aloha. And, you know, I could feel your hearts pouring out to Auntie Vicky. Now we bring it all in to all of us and to our teacher, to the Tao Calligraphy that served us this evening, Dao Quan Chu and Tao Quan Chu, and many other services that have been done this evening, of maybe that are seen or unseen, right? So let us say aloha. Aloha, 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 giving our greatest gratitude. Mahalo, mahalo, grateful for you all. Mahalo. Thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone. Love you, love you, love you. Have a great evening, and we'll see you Thursday, or maybe even tomorrow, or maybe the next day. We have lots to offer you. Love you. Take care. Have a good evening. Aloha.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you, Malia.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Good night.
Thank you. Have a wonderful evening. Aloha.